So after you've completed your storyboard and/or animatic, you can easily export it to a movie by going to the top menu and selecting File, Export, Movie. The Export to Movie dialog box opens, and the first option that you have is to choose its destination path, so in other words, where you would like to save this movie file on your computer. If you're not satisfied with the default selection, you can click on this folder icon to browse to a different place on your computer where you would like to save your file. So I'm going to click on the Choose button. Then under the Export Movie format, in the Movies format drop-down list, you can select from four different formats. So you can either export a QuickTime MOV, a Flash SWIFT, JPEGs, which indicates the export of an image sequence, or TARGA, which would also be an image sequence with a file format that supports transparency. So I'm going to select QuickTime Movie, and depending on which selection you've selected from the movie format drop-down list, the movie options will change. So in this case, I see the typical movie settings that you would see when exporting an MOV. So you can modify the video or sound parameters by clicking on the settings button. And in this window, you can then change the compression type, the quality, the encoding, etc. Then you can decide on the resolution. So by default, it's set to full resolution, which is the project size, in this case being 1920 by 1080. However, you can also choose to export it at half the size or a quarter of the size if you just want to do a quick export. Then you can decide if you want one movie clip for your entire project or if you'd like it divided into scenes, which essentially exports one movie clip per scene in your project. If you do select scene, then the Include Transitions option becomes enabled. What this means is if you included transitions such as fades between scenes, these can be included per clip, which means that if there's a fade between scenes, it will appear at either the start or the end of the movie clip. However, I'm going to go back and select per project. Next, we have the export range. So you can decide to export the entire project, or you can decide to export just selected scenes. If you select this option, then the Select button becomes enabled, which you can click on in order to open the Scene Picker window, which then allows you to select which scenes you would like to export. So you can select one or use the Shift key to select multiple. Other export range options include just exporting the current scene or just exporting the current panel. The Track Panel option is disabled because in this case we can see that we have zero panels with track changes. When using Storyboard Pro, it's possible to have someone who is modifying your project track their changes so that you're aware of any differences that they make to images, dialogue, timing, etc. And you would do this by going to the Storyboard menu at the top and selecting Track Changes. Obviously, this is disabled because I am currently in the Export to Movie window. Then you can decide to open your document folder after export, which essentially means that the movie will actually open for you to play. So I'm actually going to click on selected scenes so that we can at least see a small range of scenes and click on the export button. A dialog box appears that lets us know that the export has successfully been completed. And as we can see at the top, we have a film with the name of our project, which is SBP Rocket Rodeo, which is a quarter of the size of our project, and if we click on the play button,
all right, everyone zipped up. About time you packed up the reports and caught some theta waves too.
Yeah, I know. I just can't believe how barren this moon is. Besides a strong magnetic field in its core, it's a total flatline.
That's why they called the ship the Endurance. Terry, we take what we find and move on.
And as you can see, it's played scenes 2 through 6, including sound and transitions.